Look at these sentences. Books, this is called subject. This is in plural noun, so I use are. This is a verb in English language. Call it an auxiliary verb or main verb. It doesn't make any difference. Call it a verb indicating present tense. Books are sold. Books are printed. Books are published. Books are given. Books are written. Books are sold. Books are borrowed. Books are lent. Books are used. Books are stolen. You can make as many sentences as possible. Subject, verb, other words. What are these called? All these are called action verbs. They are called action verbs and they are in past participle form. Every action verb has five forms. Take a look here. Speak, speaks, spoke, spoken, and speaking. Every action verb has five forms. This is called base form. This is called S form. This is called past form. This is called past participle form. We are depending on this person. Now, this is called ing form. This is called past participle form. All these are called past participle forms. Books are sold, books are printed, books are published, books are given, books are written, books are sold, books are borrowed, books are lent, books are used, books are stolen. These are the actions done by somebody else. Books are not doing any action here. Something is done to the books. Books are not at all the doers. Books are receivers. Something is happening to books. Something is done to the books. And in English grammar, now I am using the terminology. This is called passive voice. Traditional teachers love to use this terminology in the classroom. Passive voice, passive voice. This is passive voice. So, no problem. These are the sentences you should use when you are highlighting the receiver, subject, but not the doer. The actions sold, printed, published, given, written, sold, have written twice, borrowed, lent, used, stolen, done by somebody else, but they are not getting the importance here. They are avoidable. They are removable. I can keep the full stop here itself. That itself indicates that they are not getting any importance here. Books are sold by them. If you want to say, you can say like this. Books are sold by them. Books are printed by them. Books are published by them. Books are given by them. Books are written by them. Books are taken by them. Books are borrowed by them. Books are lent by them. Books are used by them. Books are stolen by them. This is called passive voice. This is called present tense passive voice. Now, your progress depends on the large number of past participle forms. If you collect and add it to the living or non-living subject, then you can make more number of sentences. Now, this is a non-living thing. We have used these past participle forms to make sentences. Now, let us make one sentence for a living subject. Look at this sentence. Players are welcomed. Players are received. Players are respected. Players are insulted. Players are humiliated. Players are trained. Players are sent abroad. Subject, verb, other words, as I have told you just now, they are called past participle forms. Now, these are the actions done by somebody else, not by these people. They are not doing any action here. Something is happening to them. Something is done to them. They are not the doers. They are the receivers. This is called present tense, passive voice in English grammar. If you want to mention the doer, you can mention the doer here. Players are welcomed by them. Somebody else. Them means somebody else. Players are welcomed by them. Players are received by them. Players are respected by them. Players are insulted by them. Players are humiliated by them. Players are trained by them. Players are sent abroad by them. In this way, keep collecting large number of past participle forms which can be used for a living subject and keep on making own sentences. This is another technique, another way of framing sentences with are. Now, once you develop the confidence of making sentences with past participle forms, that is present tense, passive voice, go to stage 2 and learn the 4 forms of every example. Players are welcomed, players are not welcomed. Are players welcomed? Aren't players welcomed? Players are received by them. Players are not received by them. Are players received by them? Aren't players received by them? Players are respected in every country. Players are not respected in every country. Are players respected in every country? Aren't players respected in every country? Players are insulted here. Players are not insulted here. Are players insulted here? Aren't players insulted here? If you do this regularly, loudly, with lot of energy, definitely it is going to help you. This is for living thing. Earlier we took one example for non-living thing, like books are printed. Same, that example also can be practiced in 4 ways. Books are printed. Books are not printed. Are books printed? Aren't books printed? Books are published. Books are not published. Are books published? Aren't books published? Books are given to students. Books are not given to students. Are books given to students? Aren't books given to students? Books are given to them. Books are not given to them. Are books given to them? Aren't books given to them? This is the 6th use of are. I hope you have enjoyed this. Now let us try to see how it is going to help me in the 7th way, the 7th use of are.